In this video, I check out this pre-built PC that I came across for a surprisingly reasonable price, including 20% tax, thanks to this user on Hot Deals for posting the deal. To answer two questions, first of all, is the AWD TD500 the best pre-built for the money? And second, is it worth buying a pre-built PC to get a 30 series graphics card, as opposed to buying them at ridiculously inflated prices on eBay? To answer those questions, I've been using this PC for over a week now to not only test its performance in games, but more importantly, how stable or usable of an experience it is. But first, the unboxing. First thing we see in this surprisingly massive box is the main attraction, the 3070 MSI Ventus Edition. Funnily enough, this was the one that I wanted despite being the cheapest option, mainly because I wanted a smaller card to fit in my relatively small previous PC case. However, that is definitely not an issue here. Next, the invoice to confirm that I did indeed buy it. Then the motherboard. Jumping from a micro ATX to a standard ATX was definitely a welcome change, as my previous graphics card took all the available PCI slots on that motherboard, so at least I can get a PCI capture card in the future or something. In the motherboard, they included the Ryzen box and cables, which is nice if I want to sell components later on. Now we get to the system itself. There's a big sticker on the top telling me to keep my boxes for at least 6 months, which is important if I need to send this system off for whatever reason. And just like that, we're at the main PC. With the packaging removed, we can see how well the PC was put together. From first impressions, it looks really good. The cable management is on point, much better than my own by a long mile, and everything looks in solid condition. I can tell they took genuine care with this PC, as the packaging made it very well protected, and nothing is broken, loose, or even unplugged, which was extra important, as when I was carrying it, the handle actually broke and the PC fell. Fortunately, it wasn't on the floor, but regardless, I almost had a heart attack. All I did to change it from the stock configuration was add my own RAM and SSD, both of which were in my previous machine. So this is mainly a CPU and GPU upgrade. Now that the PC's out of the box and all set up, let's get into some benchmarks. First up is Forza Horizon 4. At 1440p ultra settings, we saw an average of 120fps from my old custom PC. A very impressive result considering the relative lack of power compared to the pre-built. However, on said pre-built, we saw an impressive 159fps. At 1440p, that is a score I'm very happy with. However, if that seems like not much of a jump, it's because the game seems to be better optimized for AMD hardware. So although 29 extra FPS is nothing to scoff at, it's not the at least 2x jump I would like it to be. Next is Horizon Zero Dawn, the second game with Horizon in the title. For some reason, I forgot to reset my custom settings, but fortunately, we still get numbers on what the hardware is capable of. At 1080p, high, roughly, we saw an average of 100fps. This game, in my experience, is much more demanding than most games. Hence, in actual gameplay, it's closer to 50fps, even with adaptive resolution. However, moving on to the pre-build, we saw at least 100fps at 1440p. And supposedly 150fps from the CPU, which means that at least 1440p 60fps should be easily doable on this machine. Then I tested Grid 2019, link in the card and description for my thoughts on the game. Because there's no formal benchmark, as far as I'm aware, I played the first track in the campaign and used RevoTuner to log the frames for me. So on my old custom machine, we saw a respectable 60fps at 1440p. For some reason though, the game was locked to 60fps, despite me enabling high refresh rates in the settings. So the GPU has a bit more to give. According to the footage though, it seems the GPU is only being utilised at 50% on average. But at least the frame pacing was on point. Using the pre-built, however, we saw an impressive average of 120fps using the same settings. A nice 2x boost in frame rate there. Finally, there's a game called Teardown, which is a game with fully destructible environments and built from the ground up to only use ray tracing. Funnily enough, this isn't actually using any of the Nvidia or AMD cores specifically for ray tracing. Hence, with how demanding this game can be, it will really push these machines to their limits. I didn't cause any destruction on purpose, ironic I know, as I wanted to have the least amount of variables. At 1440p, high, or medium, one of those, we saw an average FPS of 26. Yes, you heard that right, 26. It is especially brutal to AMD machines from what I've seen. So, how did the pre-built do? At the same settings, we saw an average of 52 FPS, the roughly 2x improvement I've been looking for. This may be the difference between not playable and playable for some people, although for me, the motion blur in this game is really well implemented, and it doesn't feel as bad as a number suggesting game. I had a few issues whilst getting those benchmark figures, mainly because the PC came earlier than expected, which, although definitely is a good thing, it meant I had to rush the benchmark and make some mistakes, so I do apologise for that. But one thing that stuck out to me is how well the 5700 XT held up, as besides Nvidia specific features like ray tracing, we don't talk about AMD's implementation, and AI, it really put up a good fight. Hence, if anyone's looking for a solid, yet lacking in creative features, 1440p 60fps gaming experience, for relatively cheap, it's a fantastic option nowadays. Moving on, I didn't choose the option for a Windows key, and as of yet, I still need to buy one. This is the second time I'm buying one so far, so that should save me a good amount of money. Now let's talk about upgrades. There are a few components that you may need to upgrade in the future, such as the RAM and the cooler for the CPU. I think the stock cooler should be good for the 5600X, but for the 5800X, it ramps up to 90 degrees whilst running Cinebench or video rendering quite quickly, and hence also throttles performance quickly as well. For most people, I'd recommend getting the 5600X version, as that's much better value for money, but because I need a beefy PC to render 4K 60 videos, I wanted to go with the 5800X for that extra CPU horsepower. With the RAM, we saw surprisingly good performance out of games, despite it not even being overclocked or set to its rated speed. So to get even better performance out of it, I'd recommend upgrading to at least 3000MHz RAM from the base 2444MHz that I got as standard. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see a video comparing the RAM speeds. The main issue I've been having is that for some reason, when I'm using the GPU at full capacity for more than 2 hours or so, the entire system seems to hard reboot out of nowhere. I initially thought that the CPU was overheating, but after running multiple Cinebench stress tests, the system was fine. So my theory at the moment is either it's the GPU or the power supply. I've yet to check the cables to make sure they're seated properly, or to stress test the GPU, either of which should at least reveal the problem. But either way, someone who may not know what to check in this scenario probably won't enjoy troubleshooting their new PC. I'll post it in the comments if/when I've solved it. Finally, the verdict. Was this endeavour worth it? Well, let's answer the two questions at the beginning. First, is this the best pre-built for the money? Well, I personally think so, as I've looked through Amazon, eBay, and many other UK-specific sites, only to find many PCs with RX 580s and 4-core Ryzens for like £900, or about $1,200. So compared to those, this is a steal. However, compared to my custom PC from last year, it's a much harder question to answer, as this PC has cost me £400 more than that system, although I did go with the Ryzen 5800X option. For me personally, I think it has been worth it, as I need the Nvidia creative features such as RTX Voice, as I'm using right now, and the NVENC encoder. But for people not using it for productivity, it's really hard to justify the extra money. Assuming GPU prices go back down, I'd say wait for a sale, as for £1,000, or $1,350 or less, I think it's worth it, just not at MSRP. That's even assuming you can buy it at all, as the stock went within a couple of hours. The second question is much more time dependent. Is it worth buying a pre-built instead of separate components, whilst GPU prices are excessively expensive? Unfortunately, this question very much depends on what you need. I know, the classic, it depends. But if you need the RTX features like I do, then I would say yes, as you could always try to flog the rest of the system, or your old system, off on eBay if you needed to recoup the money. But if you don't, then much like I said earlier, getting the 5700XT or buying a used 1070/1080 might be a better option for the time being. So that's the video. I don't normally do videos on PC hardware, but if you want to see more, then by all means, tell me in the comments below what you want to see. If you like this video, go buy someone a pre-built PC. They need those frames. See ya.